sauce earlier when Joe recorded us in the car on our way to Atlanta.
Apparently, it is a horrible job of recording.
but we're YouTube here. Guys. We are here now. So, now that we are here, we are going to eat as much vegan food as possible in the next 12 hours or so. So we're going to go to this place called Sevenada, which is a vegan, vegetarian co-op grocery store. Then we're going to go to...
It's the only vegan thing I want to eat.
I know we're going to go to this pizza joint because I really want them.
Donuts.
We're going to go to this donut place. We're going to just try and fit as much vegan food in as possible. This is going to be... vegan in a day. Yeah, so I just wanted to show you guys. We'll try and go to the slutty vegan too.
It's probably gonna be a crazy
But it's
line.
Probably gonna yeah, it's probably gonna be ridiculous. But that's what we're gonna do today. I hope you guys enjoy this vlog. We haven't vlogged in a while, but I'm gonna try and make it informative. So this vlog is going to be Atlanta vegan in a day, maybe. We'll call it that. I don't know. Maybe I'll change that name around, but that's basically what this vlog is going to consist of, is being vegan in Atlanta for a day. And I have to go get my feet done before we go to New Orleans. So, there's that. Also, we're in a really cool Airbnb, guys.
It's a tiny house.
So, yeah, it's like our version of a tiny house living.
Yeah.
The little kitchen over there. And it's so nice in here, though. Very spacious, very airy, very clean.
Yes.
It's nice. Okay, so we made it to Sevenanda, and first I'd like to say that I love the brown representation in their board of directors and their membership. I thought that was really, really cool. So when you first walk in, you're greeted by their produce section. All of their produce is USDA organic. They also have some produce fresh cut if you do just want to purchase it. So I thought that was really cool. If you want to learn more about this grocery store, please check out the link down below. It will send you to a blog post that I did regarding all of the places that we visit in this vlog. So I hope you guys enjoy that, and I hope you guys enjoy us hanging out in this grocery store. We had a really, really good time.
You.
So in Seven Under, they have a little fast food area where you can pick up food just ready to eat already. So I got a potato salad, a gluten-free macaroni salad, and a chickpea scramble, sweet potatoes, and greens. The pasta salad, I think it was the gluten-free pasta that made it very unappealing, but the flavor and all was good. Same thing for the potato salad. I really enjoyed the potato salad. And the hot food was really, really good. We also ordered their sausage patties, but she forgot to give them to us, so we didn't get to try that. So the next place we went to was Revolution Donuts. They have a couple of locations located around Atlanta, I believe, because we did drive past a few. They are not a 100% vegan donut place, but they do have a lot of vegan options. They even make like tiered cakes and things with donuts, which I thought was really, really cool that they offer it to the vegan community. So we did in total get 6 donuts because we are gluttonous. We were really only supposed to get one, but we ended up getting 6 different donuts, an entire half a dozen, you guys. And plus, we wanted to try them because who knows when we would be back. So I got the orange pistachio. I got the carrot cake, which the carrot cake was really, really good. I wish I had tried that vanilla bean. But I got the orange pistachio, the carrot cake, the blueberry, the true blue, which is like true blueberry. Then Joe got the raspberry sprinkle yeast raised donut. And we also got the apple cinnamon fritter, because I have to have an apple cinnamon fritter if they offer it. And then Joe got the chocolate blackout cake, which is basically like a chocolate on chocolate cake donut. Here are all of the donuts that we got. I really, really, really enjoyed the carrot cake donut. That was my favorite out of all of them. The other yeasty donuts, they were very, very doughy. You really couldn't finish it because it was so doughy, and I just did not like how thick and doughy the donut was. It was very heavy. It wasn't airy like how most yeast donuts are. It was super chewy and dense. So I would recommend you go with their cake version of vegan donuts, but still try it. It's up to you, you know, whatever your preference is. Not to dog them at all, because I really even appreciate them having vegan options. Of course, we had to stop at a record store while we were there. So this is a little bit of footage of Joe playing around at Wax and Facts. Then he found another record store called Criminal Records. I will leave all the information for these record stores down below if anyone has a man that loves vinyl just as much as I do and you guys decide to go to Atlanta. These are a few record stores to check out. We'll be right back. So we were going to go to this place for lunch because it was right next to the record store, but they ended up being closed. I'll leave their information down below just in case anyone else wants to check them out. Leave a comment and let us know what you think about them if you do go. Where we did end up going was the plant-based pizzeria. And when I tell you, their food was amazing, guys. So really all they serve is calzones, pizza, and burgers. They do use Beyond. So they use Beyond sausage, Beyond meat products. And then they also make their own vegan version of bacon. RIP Nipsey Hussle. They had a photo shoot right there. But we got the Hawaiian pizza and it was delicious.
Oh.
You ran out of memory?
No, the thing didn't even start recording.
It's hot though.
Anyway, okay. Hi guys. It's Jen. And as you can see, we have already been to a few of the places. And you already know like what they were like based on my voiceover review. But everything has been good so far. And we're now leaving the plant-based pizzeria. And when I tell you I am full as a tick, I'm full as a tick. So we have had breakfast, we have had donuts, we have had pizza, and now we are on full. Slutty Vegan opens at 4 o'clock and they close at 12. But we're already going to dinner with one of our friends. So we may not be able to get Slutty Vegan in. But because Atlanta is so close, we can just come back and we can do this again. And we can do like Vegan in a Day Part 2 or whatever. But in that crystal store, I got a bracelet with all of the chakras. So I'm good. I'm covered. But yeah, that's it.
So for dinner, we went to this place called Urban Fix, which is a vegan restaurant in Atlanta. And this was recommended by our friend VJ, and it is a vibe. Like, this would be a perfect place to come to on your birthday or on a special little date. It's just a very pretty view when you go inside. I just love the way that it looks in here. It looks like you could reserve for a birthday party or something really intimate and just get really cute and go out. We don't have a place like this in Charlotte. I guess the closest thing would be the Fern for like brunch or something, or to go to Luna's Living Kitchen. But their food is not cooked. It's raw vegan, so we don't have a place like this. It was a vibe, y'all. A whole vibe. So much so that Joe Milly rocked.
Yeah. I haven't really rocked in a while. It's a little rusty, but I'm still the champ.
No.
I am. Who's better than me?
I'm better than you. Milly rocked.
Okay, I'm going to bring Millie the Snapchat out.
Rocking.
Let me show you.
The food was absolutely delicious. I did a blog post on all of the food that you see here. So you guys can know exactly what the names of them are called, but every single last one of these appetizers were bomb. Every single last one of them. And I'd never had a steamed bun before. That steamed bun was everything. Now this was King Oyster mushrooms, which I thought were going to be not King Oyster. I thought they were just regular oysters, so that was a little confusing. It still was okay, but the texture was off. And then everything else you can see in the blog. We did have that chocolate mousse. The chocolate mousse was delicious, and they had the peanut butter chocolate cake. And the desserts were awesome. And then we just ended the night strolling around downtown Atlanta and being goofy and having a good time.
What up, tube of the youb?
We made it.
I'm introducing you.
It'd be oh, here with we a go. Screen.
Finish it.
No, you gotta keep it the long way or it can't go in the...
Oh, my bad. Okay, yeah. Do it again.
Yes, it has to be. Yeah. Thank you. There we go. Yeah,
landscape. We in a little bridge. I don't want to trip. Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God.
Lit.
Oh, my God.
Lit.
Lit. So, we just left... Where did we go eat?
Urban
we
Fix.
Just left the Urban Fix, yep. And we had a yummy, yummy dinner. And their dessert was really, really good. I give their dessert a higher score than I give their food, for real, for real. That damn chocolate mousse was an 11 out of 10.
Ooh.
Yeah. That was good.
Oh, y'all live.
I got that.
But it ain't like Cali, though.
I got that food, baby.
Cali's better.
Isn't that like that Cali food?
Right.
But... I'm not gonna say that y'all not out here trying in Atlanta.
But it's better than Charlotte, though.
It's
so what we're
than
so
that.
What we're not gonna
no,
do?
No.
Oh, okay.
It's better than that Charlotte food from the.
I'm gonna scream. We got a fan. You got a fan, Jan.
That do not season their food.
You got a fan, Jan.
No.
I'm finna scream.
You have me scared.
Thank you guys so much for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe. Next week we will be vegan in New Orleans. So I can't wait to share footage from our visit to New Orleans with you guys. Be blessed and stay stress-free. And you can also stay tuned to the end of this video to see a little bit of my vlogging in Raleigh. The weekend before Atlanta. Okay, so it started off with breakfast for my best friend's graduation. I made an entire vegan spread for them and they really, really enjoyed it. So that was awesome. I had to share that with you guys because their plates were clean. And while I was in Raleigh, I had to visit my cousin. We ended up meeting up for lunch at this place called Solely Vegan Cafe. They had an Instagram, but it was recently disabled. I'll still link it down below. I don't know if they are shut down or what, but I'll still put their information down below just in case they are not. Because my cousin is not vegan, she just ordered some candied yams because those are universally good. And I ended up getting a full spread. I had collard greens, I had the barbecue jackfruit, the mac and cheese, the rice, and the yams. Everything was absolutely delicious. One note I can say is they know their flavor profile. Another thing is... The only thing I would say bad is that their macaroni noodles were a little overcooked, so they were a bit mushy, but the flavor was definitely there. So it's definitely a place worth checking out and giving a try if you are in the Raleigh-Durham area and you want some good vegan food because their flavors were on point. And then we ended up finishing off the day at Duke University. They have a koi pond or a garden there. So we went to hang out there and chill with the koi fish for a little bit, and it was so beautiful. Sorry for the sideways camera, but most of this footage was captured on my iPhone. But yeah, it was awesome. So I'll leave information down below regarding all of the places that were visited during this vlog. Once again, I hope you guys have a wonderful, wonderful week, wonderful month, wonderful year, and I will see you guys in my next video. Please don't forget to subscribe. Bye!